is Yezi. Welcome to the presentation for PostMe's Fall Winter 2018 campaign. There will be two parts of this presentation today. Firstly, I will introduce my creative idea through the storyboard here, and then we will move on to the PowerPoint over here to look into more details of this campaign. So this is my storyboard, and the theme of the story is based on reviewing the histories of all PostMe's female collections. And the key message, which is trying to send out to the target audience, is the style is never fade. So the story has happened in the PostMe's Design Museum, which launched in 2016, and they are doing exhibitions of all PostMe's female collections, from the very first one to the most recent one. And then there is a middle-aged lady walking to this museum and wistfully browsing around in these exhibitions. She looks a little bit emotional, maybe because she was at the very first PostMe's female collection campaign in her 20s, or she has some connections with the design of the PostMe's female collections. She's looking into the photos very carefully, and then that will be cut to live footage from the PostMe's 1997 female collections campaign, because that's his very first female collection campaign. And then you will move on to the PostMe's 1997 female collection catwalk show, and that collection is the first time PostMe's female collection got fashion award. After that, the camera will come back to this middle-aged lady, and this time it will be focused on the products that she's wearing. She's wearing the iconic pieces from the PostMe's Fall Winter 2018. And again, after that, it will come back to the PostMe's 2009 fashion show. By the end of this story, this lady is still browsing around in this museum, and the picture is fading out. The PostMe's logo will be appear at the very end of this story. So the soundtrack music you will use is Blue by Troye Sivan and Alex Hope. I really like this music because it's very classic, slow music, but got an upbeat part as well. So it's kind of aligned with the PostMe's brand value, which is classic with twist. Is represented their value, and also because it's quite slow, it really fits into the story very well. There are a few key points I want to point out. Firstly, the model choosing for this campaign. So this campaign is targeting a brand new market segment, which is women over 50 years old. So the model used in this campaign will be aged between 45 and 55. The reason for that is the involvement framework will be conducted in this campaign. So we want the target audience is feel more involved in this advertising. So this lady is represent the target audience, and because she is the target audience. And also through the comparison of the image of this middle-aged lady and the young models who's wearing the previous collections, it will create a visual shock for the target audience. And through the comparison, this middle-aged lady, she looks nothing less than the young models. She's more confident, she's more elegant than the younger ones. Therefore, it will send out a positive message to the target audience. Secondly, the theme is reviewing the history of PostMe by looking at his period collections. It's telling the customers even the time may be changed, the definition of fashion will be changed, the trend of fashion is changing, but all the PostMe female collections stand for PostMe style, and this is never changed. And that's the second point of this campaign. And the last one is this advertising will be, or the camera will be on the slow motions. The reason for that is we want the target audience to look more details of the products, because by the end of the day, the products itself will be the key aspect that to attract the customers and goes to the shop to purchase it. So slow motions give the chance for the customers to really look into the details of the products, and it will be encouraged sales for the target audience. So now we're going to move on to see more details of this campaign. So based on our research, this is the customer persona that we're built up. So more precisely, the campaign is targeting the female customers aged between 50 and 65. We chose in this age range because lots of the ladies within this age range, they're still working. And based on the Postme's design style, lots of their clothes is really suitable for work. So functionally, will be more attractive to the target audience. And also, if the ladies they are working, they have more disposable incomes to afford the high-end fashion products. And one of the Postme's brand value is to contribute on people's lifestyle. So the target audience lifestyle could be require higher quality of life. So the product's quality and design is more important than price for them. They could be the people interested in art or music. In this way, they will feel more involved and aligned with this campaign. The purchase motivation could be the customers who really cherish the heritage of classic British style, but meanwhile, they are looking for something different or something creative from the design. Also, if it's brand new customers, the motivation could be the customers trying to be more adventurous of the products and trying to experience something new. The market communication objectives focus on three aspects, which are trying to make the target audience knowledge about the female collections and trying to change the way how they feel about this brand, and also at the end act on the purchase. So more precisely, the objectives are increasing the awareness of the female collections of Postme's and changing the customer's perceptions away from male-oriented. And then at the end is to encourage and increase the sales for Postme's. These are some content details of this campaign. So firstly, the main characters. Like I mentioned before, the model who's used in this campaign will be aged between 45 and 55. The reason for that is not just because she could be the representative of the target audience, but also it's based on the customer's mind as well. Based on the research from Mintel, the customers are expecting the diversity of the model they've seen in the campaign or the fashion shows. And the diversity could be from the model's race, the age, the size, etc. And also, not many of the fashion brands intend to use older age model because they're worried they will send negative message to the target audience. But the trend is changing now, and also if the brand using the older age models wisely, it could really differentiate this brand from the other brands. The product using in this campaign is very important as well. So it needs to be fashionable, it needs to stand for Postme's style, and more importantly, it needs to be suitable and wearable for the target audience. Because based on the Guardian's research, the majority of middle-aged customers, they simply just want to look healthy and stylish and modern. So over-fashionable clothes may send a negative message to them, because based on the customer's feedback, they will feel, lots of the customers saying they will feel insulted if they see the older model or the model within their age range wearing young people's clothes, which they can never wear in their real life. The appearance of the accessory is necessary because based on Mintel research, the woman is easier to invest on the accessories like handbags or jewelries. It could be the key point that lead the customers to go to the shop and start to purchase the products from PostMe's the poll positioning strategy will be used for this campaign, and because PostMe has started trying to use same products but targeting different a new market segment, so based on the repositioning metric, the image repositioning is the most important objective from this campaign. So it will be better and more effective if to promote this brand directly to the customers. So based on the definition of poll positioning strategy, it will be suitable for this campaign in comparison of push positioning strategy, which is influenced on the marketing channel organization, or the perfect positioning strategy, which is intend to influence on wider range of stakeholders. The tactic we'll use focused on advertising and direct marketing, and the tools gonna use is TV advert, social media, magazine advertising, and direct email. So the TV advert will run from the August, which a month before the products actually launch in store or online, because one of the new function of the TV advert is to raise awareness and contribute to changing the brand perceptions to the target audience. So using the TV advert before the product launched will preheat the market for PostMe's new collections, and it will run twice a day on ITV and Channel 4, which are the most watched TV channel in UK for 7 weeks. And after that, it will switch to weekend only during the popular and culture TV programs. The social media is used because there is a trend of middle-aged customers start using social media to connect with other people, and the population is still growing. So the social media could be used. The social media is used to target the customers through the PostMe's official channels. The Instagram will be used more because the visual content will make the campaign more impressive and more memorable to the target audience. So the Instagram is really focused on the visual content, so the image and videos of the campaign will be more often posted on Instagram. Magazine advertising. Magazine could be used as PR and advertising, but for the purpose of this campaign, it will be focused on the magazine advertising. The image of this campaign will be published monthly from September to December on Cosmopolitan, Marie Claire, and Vogue. Those are the women's best-selling fashion magazine in UK. The reason for using print media. Using magazines is because it has been proved by Mintel research the press is still remaining the most important channel for advertising designer brand, and also the print advertising can have a huge impact on sales. So one of the objectives is increase the sales for PostMe, so that will be suitable for this campaign. Direct email. So the first email, which including the image of this campaign, will be sent to the target audience the day after the product launched. And after that, weekly newsletter will send to the audience until the end of December to keep reminding the customers the products that they're having and what's in season, what's the trend of PostMe's. Even though the direct email have very high opportunities and be ignored by the target audience, or it might be marked as spam email, but the brand still can benefit from low cost of this method, and also they are still the most effective method to reach the middle-aged customers, and then the direct email can reach the target audience more precisely. And at the end, it will be more effectively to encourage sales. And this is the reference. So to sum up for this campaign, The campaign is using stories and music to make the customers more involved in this campaign. The key message trying to send out is sales never fade. The pole positioning strategy will be used to conduct in this campaign. To achieve the objectives, the TV advert, social media, direct email, and magazine advertising will be used in for this campaign. This is my whole presentation. If you have any questions, please let me know, and thank you very much for watching.